Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we're going to look at where we left off in a previous video of getting a viral sign up into an organization that didn't exist in Microsoft before, but now you need to manage that tenant. How do we do that? So enough of all this talking. You know, we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So we are logged in with my asaxon@gicdemo.net. And what we've got here is an unmanaged tenant. And so let's go to the Microsoft 365 waffle and let's see what we got here. We got Power BI and we got admin. So let's go to admin. And when we go to admin, it basically is telling you here that, look, there is no declared admin. There could be other users that are in this unmanaged tenant, but no one has stepped up and said, I am the admin, I am managing this tenant. So let's talk about what you need here. There are a couple things. First and foremost, make sure that you're actually the person within your organization that should be doing this. If that's not your role, don't do this. The other thing that you need to have is for the domain in question, you need to have DNS access to this. You need to be able to manage the DNS because there's an entry that you're going to have to add in order to verify that this domain is legit and you can continue. So if you don't have that, then you're not it. And you need to go talk to whoever the admin is in your organization that would have that information. Okay, in this case, I am that person. So let's go ahead and hit next. And this is what it wants you to do. So it needs to verify the DNS entry. And so we need to add a TXT entry into this. And so you'll see that it detected that I'm hosting my domain on GoDaddy. And so what we need to do is add a TXT record with that value. So let's go over to that and we'll add a TXT record. We're going to put the at sign, actually. Let's not leave it blank. We'll just do that. And then we'll save. Dating DNS may take a second or two. Typically, you should wait a few minutes here, but normally my experience is this happens fairly quickly. So then we'll go back to our page, confirm the record. You are now the admin of GICDemo.net. You have the keys to the kingdom. You are the admin. You are the only admin at this point because you're the first one that did this. So let's go to the admin center. Now, one thing I found is it could take a few minutes for this to actually work correctly. I had to wait last time on my test demo. So let's go ahead and we're going to sign out and then back in and see if this gets going. After waiting a little bit, let's try it again. All right, we're in Microsoft Fabric. We'll go up to the waffle and we'll hit admin and we're in. All right, so we've got into the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. So if we come down to users, we go to active users, we can see we are the only user in this tenant and we have successfully taken over the tenant. And if we come in here and we come down to roles, we can see that we are the global administrator of the tenant. And so the global admin role, this is the Uber role for Microsoft 365 or for Entra ID tenants. Directories, whatever you want to call it. This is the ultimate admin of the organization. You can also have what's called a fabric administrator. So let me know down in the comments if you want to learn more about the roles and permissions and things like that. Happy to do a video on it. I love all things administration. We went from an unmanaged tenant to a managed tenant and a declared admin. It's an adventure. And hopefully this helped you out. Let me know down in the comments if you have any questions overall. Would love to answer those for you. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.